enemies are an open tome.
Hi, everybody.
To begin with, I know you have taken a life in cold blood.
Damn it!
And I know you have looted the corpses of those you have slain.
Maybe. Yes.
I know you have used treacherous poisons to debilitate your enemies.
Yes, you got... Yeah, I have definitely done that, yes.
I also know you have come from the future. And why is that? Is your desire for power so great that you would break even the laws of time for it? It makes no difference. You will not take it from me. You would not be so foolish as to break my law.
You mean the Dwarves' law?
I mean my law. I made it because your kind would be incapable of order, of peace, without it.
Oh. So that would make you...
That makes me the Arbiter. I am also the founder. I discovered this site millennia ago in the deposit of Ethereum beneath us.
Oh.
I laid the foundations.
Of course it is.
I watched my children grow and learn and use the Ethereum to create marvels, technological wonders.
Right.
But they grew quarrelsome.
Yeah.
And used their knowledge to create weapons to use against their own kind.
Yeah.
And worse, their own father.
So you've got trust issues, is what you're saying.
So I confiscated their weapons and declared my law that each and every one of my children would live in perfect order, or they would not live at all.
I see.
And here I am, millennia later, still waiting for children worthy of this city.
Okay.
And for my patience, it seems my reward is a visit from you, Dovahkiin.
Okay.
Well, why have you traveled through time to come here? What is it you seek?
Katsuragi? Actually, I have some questions for you.
Ah, if only you could read my memories as I read yours. Very well. Ask your questions.
So, you're the one killing all these people?
You flock here, your kind, like moths to a flame, driven by greed and the lust for power.
Yeah. But yeah.
You are warned about my law. And when you disobey, and you always disobey, you force my hand, bringing death upon yourselves.
Uh-huh.
So you ask if I am the one killing your kind. And I say no. You kill yourselves.
Oh.
I am merely the means by which you do it.
Oh, arbiters don't kill people. People kill people. Oh, I see. How long have you been down here?
2,000 years in your terms. But time is different down here. I count time in waves, generations, civilizations.
Eras, maybe?
You and your kind up above are number 322.
I'm sorry? Is that right? Okay, my mind is getting a little bit boggled here. Alright, how have you survived all this time?
You wish to be ageless, like me.
No, no!
In truth, time passes differently in here. It would take an eternity just to explain it to you.
Oh, right, okay, of course. What happened to all the rest of the Dwemer?
It is not my place to reveal that secret to you, Dovahkiin. But when they moved on from this world, I was left behind. You see, the energy that has sustained me all this time. It anchored me here. I could not leave this place if I wanted to.
Oh. Well, that's all the questions I had, yeah.
So I see. Now, state your purpose here.
Good guy Katsuragi, you can do this. I want to ask... Well, let me... yeah. His crimes have escaped your sight. He's doing bad things to people.
Speak plainly. What crimes has this self-proclaimed Jarl committed?
Oh, he's keeping a woman... Oh, this is going to kill us, isn't it? Damn it! He's keeping a woman prisoner in the Citadel where you can't see it.
I see you believe what you are saying. It seems my misgivings about your kind were justified. He and his subjects must all be purged. Now, while I commend your honesty, I am afraid you too must be punished, for my law must be upheld. Goodbye, Dovahkiin.
Don't goodbye me. Oh, you're gonna fight me now, aren't you? Of course you are. Unrelenting force! Echoviri sword. Boots, gauntlet, helmet. And... oh! And I didn't favorite the armor. So, okay, let's do this. Okay, buddy. Oh, bye-bye. Impossible. What do you mean impossible? I just hit you. That's what we do here. We hit people. Where did you go? Come on. Where are you? Where are you? I can't see you. Arbiter! Don't tell me you're glitched. Please don't tell me you're glitched. Oh. You're glitched. Oh, bye! I can see his... great. Alright, Inigo. Time to go all the way back up and try this horse and pony show again. Oh wait, here we go. Oh, wait, can I go all the way up there? What's up there? Is there anything up here? Oh, what's that? That looks important. Can I click buttons? No, I cannot click buttons. All right, that sucks. All right, I guess we're going out this door. Inigo, where are you?
Finally. Where have you been, my friend?
I was downstairs trying to find the Arbiter, who evidently took one Fus Roda to the face and died. Alright, let's get out of here. Because we've screwed up again. Well, then, I have to say, you were right. Third time's the charm. So, here we go. Come on. Come on, Inigo, let's go. God dang it. At least now we can show him what's up. Go, Katsuragi, you lazy sack of poop. Well, at least we finally got to see the Dwarven Dome, or what I would call technically a reactor, but it's not it could still be a reactor full of Aetherium that's powering the whole underground city. Forgotten city, excuse me. Alright. Okay, we can take that blasted helmet off. Run, Katsuragi, run! Come on, Inigo. We're almost out. Oh, this can't be good. Oh, keep going. Keep going. Inigo? Oh, beautiful, beautiful little cat. All right, come on, man. And we make a beeline for the lake house right now. Book it. Oh, book it. Rikus, run. Here you go. Wonder if the mayor or the Jarl is already over here. Probably. Is he in here? He is. Do your deal with the thing with the stuff.
You must stop.
You just need to
this from happening.
Do I have your lake house key? I think I do. Okay. Here you go.
What is on your mind?
Not much.
Else, just ask.
I always do. Here we go. Poof! Alright. Let's try this one more time. Heavy. Let's go by name. Where's What's-His-Nuts' helmet? There it is. Is it any different? But the power is blinding? Oh. Let's favorite that sucker. Yeah, it doesn't look any different from the other one I wear. Hi, Golvar.
You there. Where did you come from?
Just arrived.
Strange. It looks like you just came out of the Jarl's private lake house.
I did.
A what? Oh, I see. You're a little bit crazy.
Well, look.
You're in good company here, my friend.
Dude, I'm out. Sorry, I've got stuff to do. Okay. Is there anything else we need to do here? I don't think so. I think we've done everything. So let's see if we can convince the Arbiter to not do his stupid bullshit move of trying to enable his law and see if we can talk him out of it. Because that's all that's left. And the only thing that was on him was his helmet. Weird. Couldn't see his face either. Wanted to see what a Dwemer would look like. Alright, here we go. Into the mist. Actually, before we do that, let's save our game one more time. Whoa, good job. Wow. Okay. Wasn't planning on doing this much playing of Skyrim today, but... Oh, goodness. Oh, good shot, Inigo. Ooh, common soul gem. Getting better all the time. All this Dwemer stuff. Now, you notice I'm not looting everything. It's because it's really heavy, too. I know I'd eat up my cargo space pretty quickly. It's not like I need the money. Oh, I do. I don't need the sword right now. Roll in a second. This is cool. This is a cool, cool map. My goodness. Can you just die, please? There we go. How did you... They just popped! What do you do that I don't? Goodness, you're deadly. I should have known that too. I should have known telling about Metellus' stuff would have caused the inaction of the law. Alright, let's hope we can finally convince him. We've gone through this a while. Whoops.
Six
resistance is at an end.
I didn't mean to hit you if I did. We were working in awfully close quarters. Oh, hey, everybody. We're back. I keep missing when the camera turns over, so I might as well just kill the print screen, because I can't see... Well, print screen's my shortcut key for seeing my preview. I don't need it. Now I've got a screenshot. Yay! What I really need a screenshot of is something like that. Goodness. There we go. Now we're going to get two of them. I'm going to have to check that folder to make sure it's not overloaded with screenshots. And rebind that key. Really, I don't need it anymore. Because I noticed myself looking at it during the videos too, and it just looks dumb. So, yeah. So that's Ethereum. That's what this crap is. So that explains it. I should have known. Should have known. I didn't even pick up on that. Of course, I don't know if I would have been able to make anything out of it, really. But that explains the dome. Wow. Hmm. Oh, wait. Probably should take a selfie. Hang on. Hey, Inigo, come here. Selfie. So, we'll go like that. There we go. And something like... There we are. Let's see how well this does. So it's one of the F keys, isn't it? No. 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 Is it this one? No. That one? No. That one? No. No. Oh, right. No. It's not what I wanted to do. Is it that one? No. That one? No. That one? No. And F5 is quick save. Okay. Never mind. Let's actually do another save game here, because I just saw it do that message about your save game is corrupted, cannot be loaded. That's not true, so I don't want to reload a game that's corrupt by accident. Alright. Here we go. Let's go see what we can figure out. Hey, bro. I'm back.
And here you are. I've been waiting for you, Dovahkiin.
You know who I am? I know who you are.
Of course. To me, your memories are an open tome.
Man, that's something else.
To begin with, I know you have taken a life in cold blood.
Yes, I've taken many lives, actually. Probably not intentionally all of them, but yes.
And what's this? I see there is a helmet in your possession. Does not belong to you.
No, it doesn't.
It's
yours. Do I want to do that? I don't want to do it. I don't want to kill him. Well, let's find out.
You kill me? That is not possible.
Yeah, I do.
And yet, I see you speak the truth.
Yes.
You have come unstuck from your own time.
Well, yes.
Your presence here is unnatural.
You're glowing in a ball above a bunch of purple spikes.
Why have you returned with this grim trophy? Have you come simply to gloat of your foul deed?
No, 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 no. Put a stop to the dwarves' law.
Do you comprehend what you are asking me to do?
Yes.
You are asking me to abandon millennia of work.
Yes.
The very thought of it grieves me.
Yes.
And yet, you have left me with no choice, have you?
Well, you have a couple choices.
I will destroy my life's work. But if I refuse...
I'll have to do this over again.
You will destroy me.
I don't want
well
to.
Well played, Dovahkiin. You will have your wish.
Oh. I almost wish I could have persuaded him. So you'll stop all this?
I will stop. From this point forward, your kind will be free to live how they choose. In whatever chaos and squalor they create for themselves. I will destroy this Ethereum to ensure your kind can never exploit it. And you may all return to the world of man, should you wish.
Okay.
But I warn you, Dovahkiin, making these changes will create a paradox in time. The events that brought you here will never have taken place.
Good. That's the whole point.
What will become of you is difficult to predict. But that is the risk you have taken by interfering with the past.
Mm-hmm. I've already done it a couple times now.
Are you ready?
Yes, Golden Man. I am ready to get... Well, let's take a... Let me see if I can take a print screen quick. With my face on it. There we go. Yeah, I'm ready to get out of here.
Goodbye, Dovahkiin.
Goodbye, Arbiter. What happens to you, then? Oh. I was hoping we could become friends. Am I still... Oh. Huh. Whoa. Whoa. Inigo? Please tell me we can pull him through time and space.
Oh. There you are. I thought I had lost you.
No, man. No. No. We are bound through the power of friendship. All right. Hi, bro.
Hey. You started me there. Wait. I know you.
What?
You're... No, that can't be right. For a moment there, I thought you were... You know, the one the statue was meant to honor.
Oh? You're Altrius. Your sister asked me to find you.
Cassia! Oh, I completely forgot.
Mm-hmm.
I asked her to wait for me at the top of the lift, and...
Yes, you did.
I guess I got so tied up in this place that I lost track of time.
That's okay.
I'd better head back up and let her know I'm alright.
You do that.
Hey, do you want to come with me? We can chat along the way.
Well, sure. All right, go ahead.
Great. Follow me. Let's run back up, shall we? Don't want to keep my sister waiting any longer. So, you're probably wondering what I've been doing down here. I guess it's been, what, a few days?
Yeah?
I'll be honest. I came down here looking for a haul I could unload on the next merchant I met.
Mm-hmm.
I just wasn't expecting to find a thriving city. And the history of this place is amazing. Did you know that up until about 7 years ago, they had what they called the Dwarves' Law?
Yes.
Apparently there were inscriptions warning that if one person committed a crime, everyone else would pay for it.
Yep.
But they were all trapped in the city with no way out. So they lived in fear that someone would break the law and be killed.
You don't say.
One day, a strange man appeared in the city out of nowhere. They say he just walked out of the lake house, like he owned the place. And he wore this spectacular dwarven armor. A lot like the armor you're wearing now, actually.
Oh?
And a few people saw him walk into this quarry. Into a field of deadly radiation. Like it was nothing. Like it hadn't killed people before him.
Oh.
And then the ground started shaking. And golden statues were collapsing. And inscriptions were crumbling. All over the city. All at the same time.
Dominus.
Which used to light up the entire cavern. Bursts in the flame and explodes. And strangest of all, the cavern roof opens up like the petals of a flower.
Yeah?
And there's real sunlight for the first time in thousands of years.
What?
So of course, people start wondering. Did he just walk? Dismantle whatever was keeping the Dwarves' Law going? Who was he? Was he still alive?
No, I don't know.
So Brawl, the local scholar, goes down into the quarry to take a look.
Vitus.
But now the whole place is empty. But all the way at the bottom, sitting alone in the darkness. Oddest tale I ever heard.
Oh. And here I thought there was a statue of the Arbiter. Which it really should be. Poor guy. I mean... He had his heart in the right place. A very draconian heart, but he had his heart in the right place. Alright, I guess after me, huh? Oh, wow! Oh my goodness! That's... Oh, cool! This is great! Metellus?
I remember you. You're back.
You shaved!
After all this time.
How have you been since the dwarves' laws have been lifted?
Can't complain, my friend. You know...
No, you're Gulvar!
I executed Metellus. Turns out he was behind Macy's disappearance.
Yeah.
They made me Jarl.
Oh, couldn't happen to a nicer chap!
I was shocked, to be honest. But I guess they wanted someone who wasn't at all like Metellus.
Yeah?
Jarl Gulvar. Still sounds strange to me.
You'll get used to it.
And I guess I have you to thank for it.
No.
If you hadn't freed us from the dwarves' laws, Ulrin could never have overthrown Metellus.
Ulrin did it!
So, thanks.
Good for him!
I imagine you'll be moving on soon, but you'll always be welcome here. We even kept your chambers exactly as you left them.
Oh. Wasn't really much to them. Sorry.
Hello there, friend.
We can keep running. Ismar,
welcome
good to see
back.
You.
You've been gone a long time.
I have. Dooley! Where is he? Dooley? Don't tell me they moved you into the city. They moved you into the city, didn't they? They did. They did! Oh, great. Alright, good. Let's go see if we can find him. Oh, blah, 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 blah. Thank you. You know what? This armor is great, but it still really isn't me. As nice as it is, you know, I'm going to go with the armor that I made. Which I think is actually a little bit better. Yep. And he left me his helmet. I'll unfavorite that. Won't be wearing that anytime soon. There we go, Katsuragi. Yeah, it doesn't look exactly like what you'll eventually be wearing. Hint, hint. But, for right now, feels a little bit more like home. Brawl! Oh, I didn't hear you say it.
Ah, you've returned. How long has it been? 7 years. You're the one who brought about the end of the dwarves' law. Thank you.
How's it been?
Wonderful, actually. Gaia and I are still researching this place, of course. Uh-huh. But now we get to share our research with the outside world.
But good.
I must ask, what happened down there, under the city? What did you do?
I met a Dwemer called the Arbiter and convinced him to lift the law. Well, he kind of talked himself out of it. Because I had to kill him to take his helmet.
You
that became a kind of a theme.
Convinced him, you say? Well, if it is as you say, you must be terrifyingly persuasive. I only wish I could have been there to see it.
I took screenshots.
I can see that you have somewhere else to be. But perhaps one day, when you have the time, you'll let me record your story in my journal for posterity.
Sounds like a plan. Oh, but there's one more man I have to say hi to. Rykas!
What do you want?
How have you been?
Better. Now that I know I'm not being watched anymore. Still, someone has to protect this place, and that someone is me.
All right!
So you might have taken down some old dwarves or whatever. But if you start any trouble here, you're going to find yourself toe-to-toe with me.
No, I don't really need that.
Have
maybe. Maybe we have. Who's this? Dooley!
Oh, hello. Do you like my fancy new clothes?
I do!
Me, after the sky opened up, and the old Jarl died, and we got a new Jarl. Jarl Gulvar is nice. He gave me a house and these new clothes.
Good! Yourself, Dooley.
Okay, bye-bye.
Good for him. Oh, Habik! Is this Habik? No, this is Vernon!
Aren't you...
Yes, it is you. You came back after all this time.
I wasn't gone very long. Vernon, how are you?
It's you. I didn't think we'd ever see you again.
How are you doing?
Oh, so much better. And thank you for whatever you did down there under the city. You know what? I don't even want to know.
Did we ever find out about...
Everyone's a bit more relaxed, including poor old Rikus.
Yeah?
He and I are... Well, we're seeing each other.
I knew it! Turns out, I knew
he's
it!
A beautiful man once you get to know him.
I have no doubt. You know, knew it! I knew it! Again.
I know you'll be off on your next adventure soon. Still, you'll always be welcome here, my friend.
Ah, yes! Alright, well, I'm out.
Well, come on back anytime you like.
I will keep that in mind.
Hello there.
Knew it. I knew it. And I betcha, if I had known it, I could have gotten that armor off of Rikus without having to kill him. Alright, let's get out of here. Hey, are you... No way!
Dragons breathing fire in the sky. Vampires brazenly attacking people on the street. It's the end of the world, I tell you.
Oh, you'll be fine. This is the Imperial Pig that just saved your city, by the way. Very cool. Alright, let's get on out of here. Oh! Oh, he wasn't kidding, it is a lift. Alright, Inigo, get on. Come on. Come on, you can get on here. Whoop! No, you can't? Sure you can. Maybe you can't? Oh no, the Nabesh is over here. Oh, we have to get out of the way for this guy, don't we? Aha! So we just do this and go, oof! There we go.
Altrius! Thank the gods you're all right. Kept you so long.
I know. Sorry, Cass. I lost track of time again. It's just that this city is so amazing. You have to come down with me and see it for yourself. I promise. It's perfectly safe.
Well, all right. But first, let me thank our friend. Thank you so much for bringing him back in one piece.
No problem.
I really thought I'd lost him. I can't thank you enough.
You're more than welcome.
Now, I promise you a reward. This is something I always carry with me, and it's become very dear to me. I'd like you to have it.
Well, thank you.
Thanks again. My brother and I are in your debt.
That one I think I'll leave. This one I think I'll take. Alright, Inigo. Now we can go. I think we've actually done some more good here. Off into the sunset. We should see that right about... Here we go. So here we are, everybody. So now we get to see the actual credits for the Forgotten City again. What I didn't show you the first time I completed this is that we have this at the beginning. We also have also all the credit for all the things after that, too. So we have the original orchestral score by Trent Moriarty. So if you're interested in that, there's his information. And then after this, we also have the cast. And this is just one of two pages. So Damien Kane was the voice of the Arbiter. And who is Rikus? Padden Cassie Dowdy. I like Rikus. Brawl, Altrius, Brandis, Habik, Marius, and Ulrin, all Patrick Deegan. Okay, all people I don't know, not familiar with. Very good stuff, though. Very good stuff. Metellus, James McLaughlin. Let's see who else we got. Oh, Rastasia is a doxographist. Graphist. Okay. Who else do we need to know about? Vitus, Owain David. Oh, and good old Domitus. There we go. And there we go. That is now the end of the Forgotten City mod. And we can return to the city whenever we choose to. And we've got it open on our map now, so we can actually travel to it. I think we can actually we can actually fast travel to it. But I think that kind of wraps up Katsuraki's exploration of why he was so interested in dwarven stuff for a bit, maybe. I can't see my own face. Why can't I see my own face? Show me! I just don't get to see any light whatsoever, do I? Almost looks like my mustache is missing. Well, it might very well be. No. But anyway, that leaves us at the end of that episode. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for coming along with me. And thank you for humoring me for being able to go through this and for another run. I apologize. I apologize for the spoilers as well. So if you haven't used this mod, now you kind of know the secrets of it. But that's not the only ending. So play it through the way you like if you want to, because I also didn't explore any of the other motivations that end in the you getting out and actually ending with the Dwarves' Law ending. But, what I mean is, like I did with the first playthrough, if somebody dies, somebody gets killed, and you still get out, that actually is considered an ending. So you'll see how those kind of go through too. So hopefully that wasn't too much, and hopefully that didn't spoil it for you. So when I start publishing these, I'm going to have to make sure I put in the fact that they are spoilers. But I feel a little bit better about this ending. I don't feel like it was so quick and really well done. So as always, if you like what you see, please go ahead and subscribe. I will be continuing this series for quite a while now. And now that we finished up the Forgotten City, we're off to finish up... Oh, let me take a look at my list here. So after that, now we've finished off, we can cross that off our list. So now I can go to Forge Master's Fingers is the next thing to pick up. Then we can go and finish up the quest at Nightcaller Temple with Arendir, because we left him hanging a long time ago, and that's where we left to go get Inigo and use the summon. Because as you saw, it was very useful in something like this, where you can't always get him where you need him to go. And then after that, we have another episode of Quest Cleanup 101, where we start going through all the little tiny quests that we haven't finished up yet that we need to. So we'll start doing that. So come along with me if you like it. And of course, like the videos as you come along and comment as you come along, because as you've seen, the people here actually really know their stuff. It's really cool. So thank you again. You guys have a good evening. We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. All right, Inigo. Let's get out of here. And let's open Skyrim. The penitent eye is watching you. Yes, you can feel its beady gaze. Oh? Oh, well, that's all right then. Yeah, I suppose that's okay. Hey, everybody. Dead Linux again. I just started recording again. I just finished up the chunks on the Forgotten City, and I was doing some inventory cleanup 101, and we just cleaned out our inventory, and then Inigo wants to talk to me about something. So we're going to go have a seat in the inn over here in Riverwood and see what he says. He wouldn't tell it to me out here because he doesn't want to be interrupted by a wolf or a dog or some such. So let's go take a seat by the fire and see what he wants. Thought I'd bring you along for it, too.
Warm food, warm drinks, and warm beds.
Sure. Okay, so, let's see, what is it? It's,
I will aid you if I can. Good idea.
Ha! Hold down the E key! I just learned that the other day. Alright, so then I just hit tap.
It is good to be relaxing. Join me.
Am I wearing my... Excuse me. Let's see, I'm not wearing my helmet, am I? I'm not. Oh! Clunk, clunk, clank. So what do you want to talk to me about?
I think we both deserve a bit of a break. Hey, did you hear what I said to that bandit the other day?
Something about rugs. Yeah, I remember that.
That is a good one, but not the insult I am thinking of. I do talk a lot when I fight. It demoralizes our enemies.
Yes, it does.
Anyway, I said I can smell your fear. You should have washed today.
Oh, I missed it.
Just after
yeah.
I said it, though, I remembered that I too had been a bandit.
Well, yeah.
It hit me that I am at the last back on the right side.
Oh, good.
My soul feels cleaner somehow.
Yeah.
As if the bandits we fight are little pieces of my misspent past washing away.
Oh, that's a good way of thinking of it.
I am lucky I got free of that life when I did.
Yeah, well, we were both involved with
it
technically.
It would have only been a matter of time before someone like you came along and ended my wretched existence.
Oh, good. Not necessarily.
I can tell you that most bandits are completely lost. They are violent thugs with ugly minds.
Oh. Yeah,
I
guess.
Sometimes do wonder if there are any worth saving, though.
Yeah.
There must be a few, I suppose.
Sure. Why wouldn't there be?
But if you choose to live like that, you have to accept the consequences.
Hmm. It's true. Well, you obviously have your regrets.
Yes. I know that in this world, at least, killing is a part of living. We all do it to survive, for gold, or to put food in our bellies.
Well, quite literally,
but
yeah.
But taking pleasure in the death of the guiltless for nothing more than sport is wrong. Some dirt never washes off.
Yeah, no, that's true. I try to do what's right, but I have some regrets.
It is a complicated world, and it is hard to get by without putting a foot wrong. Do you mind if I ask what it is you regret?
Oh, these are good questions. Okay, so let's think about this. Let's see if we're going to RP this up a little bit. So, Kasaragi, what would he regret? Well, so, as the story goes in my head, Kasaragi and his father were raised by their grandfather who, from what I've been figuring out, must have adopted them. But what his grandfather really is, we're not sure. And what Kasaragi and his father really are, we're not sure. But the grandfather saw something in the two that seemed to him to be something that may be related to the home country. And maybe related to the only race of men that still may be around there. And so taught them that. Well, Katsuragi's father obviously wasn't able to keep much of a family together. Or maybe he was, who knows, but then went off and got himself killed. Theoretically, in the service of the Blades. Oh, shoot, I missed it!
Take it. What is on your mind?
I missed the opportunity, shoot! Aww. How did that get interrupted? It must have timed out. How are you doing, Inigo?
I am okay.
But I guess that's kind of what Kasaragi would have said. I'm doing all right.
Good. Well, let us talk of other things.
Let's see. Any thoughts at the moment?
Meridia is my kind of Daedra. She hates the undead almost as much as me. I'm glad you helped her. Dawnbreaker was well worth the trouble.
You know, I think Kasaragi probably wouldn't have answered that question because he's not sure. So maybe that was the right way to respond. Let's see. Oh, we've got so much we could do. So much we could do. Yeah, let's follow me.
Legs. We are on the move again.
I'll try to catch those moments if I can, because those are actually really important to me. I think those are make Inigo as exciting as he is. And I haven't seen very much of him. Now that I've got him fully unlocked and we can see that kind of stuff, it's exciting. So anyway, thought I would bring you guys along to see that quick little piece of Inigo, especially after we just came through the Forgotten City. And next time I'll try to think of an answer a lot faster before I lose my responses. That's just ridiculous. So, Inigo?
What is on your mind?
Any more thoughts?
I'm thinking the sun is going down.
Good call. Okay, let's get back to our house.
All
so, thanks guys. Thanks for coming along and thanks for watching that little tidbit and humoring me yet again. And we will see you guys next time. Take care.